Welcome to part 4 and the reveal of doing a reading nook for my friend's kids.
In the last part, I made this really cool peg wall,
which a lot of you didn't know why, but this will make sense now.
I'm putting in a desk in this back corner so that the kids can do artwork. We wanted this to be a space that had multi-purposes. Once I had the desk done, I did install these cute little lights that are magnetic and rechargeable, and you can move them around and use them wherever you want in the space. Now that the desk was done, it was time for the final big piece. We are putting in a climbing wall, and I recruited my husband to help out with this a little bit because lifting full sheets of plywood is just a little heavy for me. We screwed these right into the studs using structural screws, and then I got to priming and painting the wall. I even add a little trim detail just to finish off the edges nicely. Our kids are fairly young, so this wall should last them a while. And if you're worried about how strong it is, my 10-year-old daughter climbed it no problem. We also added these art frames for the kids' art. So this is where we started, and here's the final space. It's so fun designing a space on paper and seeing it come to life. This will be a space that the kids will be able to use for years to come, enjoy reading, and be creative. Thanks for following along this reading nook journey, and stay tuned because I'm about to head to another friend's house next week. Okay, bye!